We will start with a presentation by Mr. Biswal from NTPC, who I'm sure you're all familiar with. NTPC, of course, is the biggest thermal power producer, but now has got huge plans in terms of solar power, not only for buying under National Solar Mission, but also commissioning their own plants. So we'll start with the presentation from Mr. Biswal and then go over to a discussion after that.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, dignitaries, speakers on the dais and of the dais. It is heartening to see many known faces, my seniors, veteran regulators, Dr. Dev, Gaur, members, Appellate Tribunal, recognize the where Burma Sahib is here. So I feel fortunate to be here. And I thank at the outset to the organizer for inviting me and sharing my views quickly because time is very limited. You see, it was told that NTPC is the largest power generating company in the country, fourth in Asia. And we are now coming out in a very big way in solar power. So now, if you see our portfolio, 86% is coal-based thermal power plant. Now we'll reduce it to 56%. So we'll be adding renewable energy. It's not okay. Sorry. So as you know that National Solar Mission was launched in 2010, January 2010, to develop solar power. To supplement the energy requirement of the country, 20,000 was the initial, it was planned to achieve by 2022. And the target was revised to 100 gigawatts with 75 gigawatts other than solar. So this is the target, solar 100 gigawatts, wind 60 gigawatts, small hydro 5 gigawatts, biomass 10 gigawatts, and region-wise allocation, I'm not going into details because of the passage of time. This is the allocations, capacity additions, that 20 gigawatts through solar park and ultra mega solar plants scheme, 20 gigawatts through bundling and viability gap funding scheme. Essentially, NTPC is participating in two categories, and we are bringing out 15,000 through this National Solar Mission Plan and 10,000 on standalone basis. Our contribution would be 25,000 megawatts out of 100 gigawatts. It means 25% of the total country's target would be made by NTPC. And 20 gigawatts through this unemployed youth, gram panchayat, and micro, small, and medium enterprises, 40 gigawatts of solar rooftop systems. This is your allocation current year. We have to add that country as a whole, 2,000 megawatt, and year-wise given for 16, 17, 12,000, 17, 18, 15,000, 18, 19, 16,000, 19, 20, 17,000, 21, 22, 17,000, 21, 22, 17,500, 21, 22, 17,500, totaling to 97,000 megawatt to be added. So this is the power scenario in the country. Of course, this data is on March 15 now. You see, around 13% of the total installed capacity is renewable energy. And this 263 now, perhaps it has gone up to 270-273 gigawatts, out of which 36.64 gigawatt is solar renewable energy. So this is the status of a renewable energy capacity addition in the country. Wind power, we have the potential of 1,02,788 megawatt 80 meter heights, and 3,02,000 megawatt 100 meter heights as assessed by National Institute of Wind Energy. But till date, we have achieved as on 31st July 2015, total capacity, wind capacity is 23,864.91 megawatt. Similarly, solar, we have the potential based on the wasteland availability as assessed by the National Institute of Solar Energy, 7,48,980 megawatt, whereas we achieved so far 4,168 megawatt. Small hydro, 19,700 megawatt potential is there. Till date, we have achieved 4,130.52 megawatt biomass. As against 18,000 potential achieved till so far 4,418.55 megawatt. Waste to power 127.08, totaling to 36,642.77 megawatt. So these are the policies, regulatory support required for development of energy, renewable energy. Feed-in tariff in some of the states, it's there. Most of the states, it's there. Most of the states also come out with their RE policies. And presently, of course, we are showing very demand supply gap is low. But our consumption is per capita consumption is very low. It's 1,000 units per person. There is a huge demand, but our plants are running partially. So perhaps I am not going to the that area, that distribution area. But now this gap will widen, and that will also support the solar generations. Exemptions are required. In fact, excise duty, custom duties, exemptions are there. And 10 years tax holidays is also available for the renewable energy. RPO, as per the provision of Electricity Act 2003 and tariff policy, RPO is there. REC is there, REC mechanism is there as promulgated by CERC. Accelerated depreciation, this is the instrument to drive this renewable energy. It is available for solar and biomass. For wind also it is there. We have given a commitment to the government that we will add 10,000 megawatt solar energy, solar capacity by 2022. This is the replica of the certificate or commitment we have, what we have given to the Honorable Prime Minister. So this is about NTPC. We started our journey in solar power in 2013, March, with the 5 megawatt capacity at Dadri and Andaman and Nicobar each. We put 50 megawatt as Rajgarh in March and April 2014. That is the largest solar power plant of NTPC. Today we are having 110 installed capacity of solar power at 8 locations. And now we are developing world largest, we are claiming that is the world largest solar projects at in single location, that is at Anantapur district of Andhra Pradesh with 1,000 megawatts. 250 megawatts we have already awarded to the contracts, and 750 megawatt is under tendering process. We have signed MOU and also PPA with Andhra Pradesh government for 250 megawatt. So this is our solar plant. We are going to add 25,000 megawatt, 10,000 on standalone basis, 15,000 through this National Solar Mission Program. Under the first tranche of this 10,000 megawatt, 3,250 megawatt, we have already awarded 250 megawatt, and NIT issued for 1260 megawatt. Then under this, out of this 3,250 megawatt, we are going to issue 1,000 megawatt under this DCR. Andhra Pradesh 250 megawatt, MP 250 megawatt, Rajasthan 260 megawatt, Telangana 250 megawatt. Under non-DCR category, that is ICB, Andhra Pradesh 750 megawatt, NIT has already been issued on 21st August 2015, MP 500 megawatt, Rajasthan 500 megawatt, Telangana 250 megawatt. Now we are waiting the consent of the state government. Similarly, under this National Solar Mission Program, first tranche of 3,000 megawatt, DCR would be 2,560 megawatt, sorry, DCR would be 460 megawatt, and non-DCR would be 2,560 megawatt. RFS request for selection has already been issued for 2,350 megawatt. As per the new and renewable energy ministry, they have given the allocation statewise, AP 1,000 megawatt, Rajasthan 650 megawatt, UP 100 megawatt, Karnataka 600 megawatt, Telangana 400 megawatt, JNK 250 megawatt, and Odisha 20 megawatts. So these are the issues I wanted to flag, that because these are the locations where the lands are available at remote locations, where infrastructure is not there for evacuation and for logistic arrangements. Similarly, at the power, infirm power, it is infirm power and difficult to schedule. Limited generation period requires storage. High generation cost due to high upfront cost, capital cost, and low capacity factor. And so far, we are achieving only 16 to 18% in our installed solar projects. Underutilization of transmission facilities, higher land requirement per megawatt in comparison to thermal power plants. So these are the challenges I want to flag in. Financial health of the DISCOMs, unless it is improved, or whatever policy we are bringing, we may not be able to recover money from the distribution companies. Payment security mechanism, that TPS should be extended beyond October 2016. Impact on grid stability due to intermittent and infirm renewable generations, it is also a great challenge. Grid parity with the conventional source of energy, perhaps now people are claiming that solar power has already achieved the grid parity. Then enforcement of RPO. RPO is there, but it is not being enforced literally. Now government is coming out some innovative models.
Mr. Like Biswal, sorry,
we just only need two slides. I will complete. That's why I'm going very fast.
Sure.
So that's why.
Sure.
The bundling of solar power with the thermal units so that the tariff is becoming the affordable. Tariff-based competitive bidding used to reverse auction methodology so that the cost is coming down. Dollar tariff to be offered to foreign investors for avoiding the impact of exchange rate variations. That the government is working. In fact, they have given us a draft guidelines where the intermediary will pay to the developers in the form of foreign currency, maybe in the form of dollar, whereas intermediary will collect money in the form of rupee from the distribution utilities, and they will collect a little extra from the distribution utility towards the hedge funds. So that in case there is any variation, that variation would be made out of that hedge funds. Then renewable energy obligations of 5% is going to be, it is proposed in the new amendments as RGO for the coal and lignite thermal power generators. So these are the way forwards. Alignment of state government programs with the national plans and targets. Creation of a national renewable energy funds to support renewable energy technology till they become competitive with the conventional sources. Development of a dedicated green power transmission corridor. Now the PGCIL and POSOCO, they are working on this for the evacuation of renewable energy power from remote locations and minimizing the transmission distance losses. Deployment of grid balancing mechanism and energy storage technology to accommodate informed renewable generation. Perhaps somebody is there to tell about the energy storage system. Deployment of renewable energy forecasting technology, we are discussing that we are unable to sell the power if we are having technology to forecast our renewable energy generation. Perhaps that will help us in selling the infirm power, access to cheaper international funds for reduction of in tariff. That is, you know, green bonds are available, but green bonds are not cheap. It is as good as the other dollar bonds. So that should be the cheap, if cheap funds are available in the market for these green power projects, that will help in reducing the cost and policy initiative to enforce RPO and RGO. So this is all about my presentation. Thank you very much for giving a little bit extra time. Thanks a lot.